If you like the video, please subscribe Technical PCT channel and click the bell icon to get the latest videos.
Yeah, very good morning all of you. Colligative properties. In that one, the very first one, RLVP, it is finished. And even yesterday, we have taken the boiling point definition also. Yeah, regarding the Raoult's law, let us have some problems on that. Okay. See, yeah, NCERT textbook, man, the unsolved one, let us go through them. Yeah, a direct question is there. You just see, vapor pressure of pure water at 298K is 23.8 mm. Okay. Then 50 grams urea is dissolved in 850 grams water. See, calculate vapor pressure of solution and RLVP. This is the question. And RLVP, that is the question, right? So here, what is the two answers you have to calculate here? Two answers. What is that you have to calculate? P, how much? P means vapor pressure of the solution, as well as RLVP. This is also. So RLVP can be calculated easily. Is it not? The RLVP. See, first one, suppose RLVP. So for this, what you do? According to Raoult's law, P is equal to X2. What is the meaning of X2? Mole fraction of solute. Is it not? Mole fraction of solute. So, mole fraction of solute means X2 is equal to N2 by N1 plus N2. Okay. Yeah, here, what is N2 here? Yeah. See, the N2, that is, say, solute number of moles, I am saying. How many grams of urea? 50 grams of urea. So therefore, see, number of moles, weight by molecular weight. Urea molecular weight, ma? Urea molecular weight. So 60 divided by N1, that is number of moles of water. How many grams of water are taken? 850. So 850 by 18. Then number of moles of solute again, 50 by 16. So this, later you do it. That is right. So this is the way you can do. Yeah, then next one. See, if you calculate this X2, the next, another one. See, P, how much? So here P means vapor pressure of solution. Therefore, what is the formula you have? P naught minus P by P naught. it is equal to x2. It is equal to x2. So therefore, x2 value you substitute there. Already P0 is supplied. How much? 23.8 mm. That is. So therefore, from that you can calculate P, how much. X2 value, you will get it here. How much? So it is the way you can solve this problem. So I think all of you solve this. Right? The next one, little tough one, let us check. Okay, so see one thing, ma, whenever my track is going on, you please better have the calculator also. Better to have calculator. Then you can do them easily, right? So, the next problem I am going to explain. See, that is, yeah, is this finished? Is this finished? Later we finish, just not enough. Later we can simplify, not now, not now. Okay. Yeah, next one. And also one more thing, see, nearly 30 to 40% students already you have received material. You are having the material. So please, in that material, you solve the Raoult's law problems. But in that one, whenever you find ionic compound, dissociation, ionization, or association, please leave them. At the end of the lesson, we have to discuss. So there, under the heading of abnormal colligative properties, there we discuss. Presently, only the colligative properties we discuss. After that, the abnormalities, in these we discuss. Okay, don't do that problems. Later we can do. Okay, so presently, this one, ma, you please, that is, you take it. Next problem, next a typical one, let me do it. Yeah, listen, next one. Yeah, see, if you have NCERT textbook with you presently, question number 2.19 at the end of the chapter, you can find a typical one. Let me do this. Okay, all the remaining problems, you are able to do it. No problem. This one. Yeah, see, a solution containing, you can note down, a solution containing 30 grams solute in 90 grams water has a vapor pressure of 2.8 kilopascals. Further, 18 grams of water is then added to the solution and the new vapor pressure of solution is 2.9 kilopascals. Okay, calculate molecular weight of solute. Number two, okay, so please go through 30 grams of solute in 90 grams of water. First, at that time, the vapor pressure of the solution is 2.8. Now for the same solution, 18 grams water is added. 18 grams water is added. At that time, the vapor pressure increases. Okay, vapor pressure increases. We just go through the problem. Yeah, Susan. Of course, what is the law related to this? Raoult's law. See the Raoult's law. See, this is non-volatile solutes. Okay. See. Now the solution. Let us see. Raoult's law. Okay. See, solution containing non-volatile solutes. Solution containing non-volatile solute. So what is Raoult's law? It states that vapor pressure of the solution is directly proportional to its mole fraction. Is it not? Vapor pressure of the solution is directly proportional to its mole fraction. So P is proportional to X1. Mole fraction. One denotes solvent, that is it not? So therefore, we are here. Yeah, now this is the formula we have. Understand? So therefore, let us take this. Now, solution one. What is the solution one now? 30 grams solute in 90 grams water, and what about the pressure? 2.8. Is it not? So therefore, see, x1 means n1 by n1 plus n2. Is it not? And P is given as 2.8. So what is N1? Solvent. What is that? 90 grams water by 18. So 5. N2. How much? 30 grams they have taken. 30 by 5. That is. So therefore, what do you write? So, see, 2.8 directly proportional to, what is the x1? N1 by, so what is n1? 5 divided by, n1 is 5 plus n2, 30 by, sorry, this is, n2 is m, it's molecular weight, so m. That is it not? So therefore, what do you write? 2.8 proportional to 5 divided by. Right. So what do you write? That is, yeah, 30 plus 5m divided by m. Is it not? This is a small m. Are you able to see this last line also? Right? 2.8 proportional to like this. So call this one as 1. Call this one as 1. Right? So 5 divided by 30 plus 5m divided by small m. What is small m here? Molecular weight of solute. So this is okay, like this. Then in the same way, let us take, see, solution 2. In solution two, what happened, ma'am? Same 30 grams solute, 30 grams solute in 90 plus 18, 90 plus 18. Okay, 90 plus 18. How much it is? 108 grams water. 108 grams water. And at that time, the pressure found as 2.9. So therefore, again here, the same thing, Raoult's law apply. So according to Raoult's law, what do you say? Like this. Is it not? So now you calculate the x1. What is x1? You will say that n1 by n2. So what is n1? So 108 by 18. That is 6. What is n2? That is 30 grams by small m. Is it not? So therefore, see, x1 is this, and this is n1. Number of moles of water, 108 by 18, so 6 moles. N2, 30 divided by m. Molecular weight of the solute. So therefore, what do you write now? That is, see, you can write now, 2.9 proportional to N1, 6 divided by 6 plus 30 by M. Is it not? So therefore, what do you write? 2.9 proportional to 6 divided by 6 M plus 30 divided by small m. That's. Is it not? This is 2. This is 2. Therefore, this is equation. You do one thing now. See, equation 1. See, equation, suppose 2. Yeah. Any, your wish, that is. See, equation 2 divided by equation 1. Equation. Calculate small m value. Small m, you will get that value as 23. After getting that. So, this is first answer. Okay, molecular weight of solute, then vapor pressure of water, P naught. So, for that, what you can do? Any equation you get, no problem. Any equation, say, Raoult's law. Say now, P naught, question mark. So, therefore, Raoult's law, I am saying, what do you write, ma? P is equal to P naught x1. Okay, P is equal to P naught x1. So therefore, see, suppose now you consider any solution. Consider solution 1 only, no problem. Solution 2 or solution 1, your wish. Then suppose consider one, solution 1. Solution 1 means P is how much? 2.8. This is P naught. Then what about this one? N1 plus N2. That is. So therefore, see, 2.8, it is equal to P naught. N1 value. How much N1? 5. Divided by 5. Plus N2 value. 30. By 23. So you can calculate P naught or not. Yeah, that is. It is the way you should calculate. This is previous IIT question. Of course, it is given in our NCERT textbook. That is. Okay, see, time consuming. I'm saying time consuming. Of course, see, to write the chemistry exam, whether it is a NEET, otherwise the mains exam, time is sufficient. Actually, you will save the time in this, and you can utilize this to do the physics also. So you please see, this is the another one now. Okay, so this is understood now. Please, all of you go through it, ma. All of you, please see. This is the question. Then solution one I have taken, and for that, how it is related? P is proportional to x one, or of course P is equal to P naught one into x one. No problem, right? That is so like this. Finally, this is equation one. Next, in the same way for solution two also. Solution two for that also we have we derived equation two. Now equation two by equation one, or equation one by equation two, whatever it is, do it. You will get the answer, molecular weight of solute 23. Yeah, then next one, P naught. Second one, that is second one. How? So any either solution one or solution two, you apply, you will get answer. You will get answer. That is so. This is the typical problem in that. Yeah, let me go through any other problems also, difficult one. Okay. Yeah, one more. Let us see. One more one. 2.18 also. Let us do. Yeah. See there. If you have already have taken, no problem. Otherwise, take the screenshot. That is. Yeah. Listen. So I am going to rub this one out. See. Yeah, we have gone through your chart also. Now, yeah, almost all of you actually. Yeah, I'm feeling so happy that many students actually, I'm observing. See, they are giving the answers itself very immediately. Really excellent one. Really, I feel so happy. Really, and at the same time, see, any other subject related to this, please don't put that. Please, only chemistry, only chemistry. And also, please, one more thing also, you please remember. Now, presently, in our Sri Chaitanya, do you know what is the net speed? What is the package we have? Right, 100 MB/s. Please remember. Right, and then so please see. Daily we are able to use, that means we have a capacity to use 100 GB. Remember that. So therefore, and also one more thing, while a class is going on, any lecturer's class is going on, see, all the staff, especially the computer lecturers, really excellent. They are doing a lot of job here. Actually, do you know that lecturers and other vice principals, they are, see, continuously they are also listening the classes. They are also listening the classes. And any, see, whenever, suppose, see, actually here, just like Pakistan border, they have given a mark also. That means we should not go beyond of that mark. We should not go beyond of that mark. Okay, within that only we should do like that. And also suppose, by mistake, if we go, very immediately they inform us. So now, see, the Trinetra is watching everything. Understand? Please remember that. Right? And also, one more thing. Whenever any blur is there, voice is not audible, very immediately they will come and say to us. So, such that what we are doing from our side, we are making us everything perfect. That's why, whenever you feel difficulty in video or audio, please leave the session immediately and again to come back sometimes. Okay, because and also check your net speed, otherwise change your mobile, please. That is because from our side, from our end, we are doing at the most best. Please remember. And at the same time, just now I said, you know, I appreciate the majority of you. Really, they are giving answers very immediately. That one, really nice one. You please follow us. See, definitely, let us make this program success, and also let us use these days, not vacation. This is these days, right? Excellently, right? Then after, see, after 1 year, that means by the next year, the same period, I think definitely you will be going to write the NEET exam. Same, May first week, I'm saying, only 1 year is there, only 1 year, right? So till I feel July or August, we have to continue with this. So need not worry, already almost all of you are adjusted with this, right? So please be sincere, don't waste the time. Understand, right? We are giving utmost all the points with respect to the PU, with respect to the NEET as well as the JEE, all of us. And also, see, I'm already getting the doubts, and then they are giving the screenshots. I'm giving the, very immediately the solutions also. That is, so please see the concern sections. You too, if you feel the problem, you please post that in your WhatsApp group. You will get doubt clarified very immediately. If not, put that into the principal house. No problem. They immediately will take the action, and they will inform us, and they will tell you. No problem. That is, you are most encouraged to ask the doubts. Ultimate aim of Sri Chaitanya is to make you to feel a grand success in all the exams. Please cooperate with us. Because ultimate is your cooperation only. Otherwise, we can't do anything. Okay? So now, the next one. Calculate the mass. In your NCERT textbook, it is 2.18. Calculate the mass of solute. Its molecular weight, that means small m, it is equal to how much? 40, which should be, which should be dissolved in 114 grams, obtain to reduce its vapor pressure to 80%. That is the percent. Okay? So, alkane. It is an alkane. So, C8H18. Is it not? What about the molecular weight? Carbon 12, 96 plus 18. Okay. See now, what is the formula? See, the vapor pressure should be 80%. That means initially it is 100, further it has been reduced to 80. So therefore, see, you can say P naught is 100, then P is 80. Small w you have to calculate. Small m 40. Right. Capital W. How much? That is 114. Capital M 114. So what is the formula you have? P naught minus P by P naught is equal to like this. So all the values are supplied. So small m you have to calculate. Small m you have to calculate. Right? So that is another problem. So any other different model? Let us see. Yes, later you can do. Okay, next one. Yes, see. Weber, next problem. Next problem. Weber pressure of water. Weber pressure of water is 12.3 kilopascals. Kilopascals. So, calculate Weber pressure of 1 molar solution. That is. So therefore, here water is the solvent. That is right. Then Weber pressure of 1 molar solution. See now, what is the formula we have? This is the formula. P naught minus P by P naught, it is equal to, and last class we have taken the molality relation also. So molality means, what do you say? Small W by M, right? 1000 by, see, this is the formula. Is it not? So therefore, see, what is the formula you get now? P naught minus P by P naught is equal to what do you write? That is. So do like this, 1000 by 1000. Is it not? That is. So therefore, you can say molality into capital M by 1000. Capital M by 1000. So, see here, all the values are supplied. See, P naught is given. P naught is given 12.3. Then P, you have to calculate. Then capital M, water. So, 18. Molality, 1. 1. So, therefore, you can do the remaining. So this is another problem. Okay. Yeah. Those are Raoult's law problems. Raoult's law problems, right? Yeah, then see. Okay. Yeah, then after this, I will go to the next colligate property. Okay. Yeah, I am going to rub this one. Right? Yeah, you can take the screenshot also otherwise. Yeah. See, listen. Elevation. See the next colligative property. Elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point. Right. So let us take that. See, yesterday we have seen the meaning of boiling point. Boiling point. What is the meaning of boiling point for a given liquid? You will say that. See. The temperature at which vapor pressure of the liquid equals to atmospheric pressure. Is it not? That one. And then water. What is boiling point? 100 degrees C. Right? At 100 degrees C, what is the vapor pressure of water? That is how much? 1 atm. Bar means 1.013 bar. Right? Centimeters of Hg, 76 centimeters of Hg. mm, 760 mm of Hg. Is it not? So, let us take them. Now, see, elevation in boiling point. Let us see the meaning of this. Elevation in boiling point. Delta TB. Delta TB. So, listen. Elevation. Elevation. Name itself indicating. More. So, listen. Solvent boiling point is some value. Suppose water. Water. Its boiling point is 100 degrees C. Now, some salt is added. What is the boiling point of the solution? So, boiling point of the solution is more. So, here you can have a graph like this. Vapor pressure, right? This is temperature, right? Temperature, and then this is 0, this is 1 atm, like this, 1 atm. So, like this. This is the vapor. Okay, this is, say, solvent always will have more vapor pressure. Solution will have less vapor pressure. So therefore, that is. So solution will have more boiling point. Solution will have more boiling point, TB. This is T0B. T0B. What about the difference? Delta TB. The difference is delta TB. Remember that is. So it is the way. Okay. So therefore, delta TB is equal to TB minus T0B. Is it not? So here TB, that is boiling point of solution. T0B, boiling point of solvent. So delta TB is equal to KB into molality. KB into molality. So here, what is KB? So this is molal elevation constant. Molal elevation constant. It is called as, right? Then ebullioscopic constant. Okay. Otherwise, boiling point constant. It is called as boiling point constant. Simple one. One more thing. What about the units of KB? Units of KB. So for that, what do you say? Say, let us derive. So KB is equal delta TB by molality. Is it not? So delta TB means K. Okay. Moles per kg. Is it not? So K, that is right, into kg per mole. That is important, because once they asked, simple as it, but examination tension,
examination tension. So the students have lost marks here. That is a problem. Okay. So please remember this. Okay. Anyhow, next one. Next one. One more here. See. TB, see, this is the formula we have. So we can write like this. TB minus T naught B, it is equal to, see, KB into molality. KB into molality, is it not? TB minus T naught B is equal to like this. T naught B is solvent. Now, TB and molality, how they are related? Directly proportional. See, if the solution's concentration increases, its boiling point also increases. So, boiling point of solution directly proportional to concentration of solution. Please remember, in this lesson, they will ask you like this. 0.1m, 0.2m, 0.01m, like that they give. And you will be questioned, which solution will have more boiling point. Please, this is one important point. And also for KB or M T naught B square by 1000 delta H B. So what are they? R, gas constant, remember. M, molecular weight of solvent. T naught B, already you know, boiling point. Delta H B, enthalpy of vaporization. So especially IIT students, the engineering aspirants, if you are attempting mains and advanced, concentrate on this. They will give problems not on protein colligative properties. They will put questions on KB. Please remember that. Okay. So that is, please remember. So this is one important formula, right? Yeah, then see one more, that is, see, majorly these I'm saying. Okay, so remember this. Then tomorrow, problems on this as well as depression in freezing point, we can finish, right? And also one more thing, for coming weekend, again, okay, see, concentration methods, theory type of the questions, then slightly the vapor pressure, Henry's law, okay? So you please concentrate on them again, the questions you are going to have those only. So once again, you practice them, right? Then, thank you all of you. Good day. Yeah.